Chartreuse. Chartreuse is a French liqueur made by the Carthusian monks since 1737, according to the instructions set out in a manuscript given to them by Francois Annibal de Estrees in 1605. It is composed of distilled alcohol aged with 130 herbs, plants, and flowers. History of alcohol. Ancient Greece, while the art of winemaking reached the Hellenic Peninsula by about 2000 BC, the first alcoholic beverage to obtain a widespread popularity in what is now Greece was mead, a fermented beverage made from honey and water. However, by 1700 BC, winemaking was commonplace. Guinness. Guinness is an Irish drink stout that originated in the brewery of Arthur Guinness at St. James Gate, Dublin, Ireland, in 1759. It is one of the most successful beer brands worldwide, brewed in almost 50 countries, available in 120. Sales in 2011 amounted to 850 million liters. Red Stripe. The brand was first imported to the United States in 1993. 51% ownership in Dennis and Geddes Limited was purchased by Guinness Brewing Worldwide, now Diageo, an acquisition that significantly increased the international distribution of both Red Stripe and Dragon Stout. Heineken. Heineken Lager Beer, or simply Heineken, is a pale lager beer with 5% alcohol by volume, produced by the Dutch brewing company Heineken International. Heineken is well known for its signature green bottle and red star. And finally, whiskey. Whiskey is a type of distilled alcoholic beverage made from fermented grain mash, various grains which may be malted are used by different varieties, including barley, corn, rye, and wheat. Whiskey is typically aged in wooden casks, generally made of charred white oak. Whiskey is a strictly regulated spirit worldwide, with many classes and types. The typical unifying characteristics of the different classes and types are fermentation of grains, distillation, and aging in wooden barrels. Also, the last one is gin. Gin, I know, is made of juniper berries. I say this to say that for years, I remember growing up watching my family and friends get together, and alcohol was always key in their socializing, not to the extent it probably is today, where it's become such a huge, vast thing within that socialization period. But it was something that I remember my elders teaching us about when we were very young, about the history of alcohol and how it was used for a lot of healing. And when we were small, we were given like a capful, maybe once or twice a month, maybe more like a medicine than anything else. And I remember a mason in our family who was teaching us about the fact that rum, or alcohol, when diluted with an 8-ounce glass of water, they use, I don't know if it was just a mason thing, but they use it as medicine. Now, what I noticed was whenever people who were drinkers stopped drinking, when they went to the doctors, and the doctors told them to stop drinking, and they did, all of a sudden they start to develop all these different ailments. And I couldn't understand why. I couldn't figure out why it is they stopped drinking and were now taking these medications. And as a result of that, either they start to get sick just shortly after they stopped drinking, or they started taking medication and then got sick. vice versa. Either way, it was just this pattern that I started noticing. So I started researching alcohol many years ago, and I was researching it with a friend of mine who, a European, well, actually, I think now we probably figured out there are more, but they look Caucasian. And she was telling me that there are different types of alcohol that one can consume that is alkaline. And that's when we discovered Glenfiddich whiskey. I'm not getting paid for any of this stuff, but Glenfiddich whiskey, chartreuse. there's something about the red star. When you see that show up, she was saying that's a really good symbol. So, of course, Heineken. Then when we were growing up, there was always Red Stripe, but Red Stripe was bought out by Canada and they switched the entire ingredients in there. So it's crap now. So nobody, like, people still get it, but it's garbage compared to what it was when they first brought it out. Anyways, I say this to say that people, those of you out there, we met someone yesterday. It was kind of disheartening to see that we know personally who was going through a trying time, and some other people we know have had some issues with this stuff. Known as alcoholism. And we saw them and we were trying to figure out, they told us the story as usual because, you know, they kind of needed notes to get that fix and whatever. And I'm not against anything necessarily, but I say this to say that those of you out there who are drinkers, gin is a very good thing to drink as it's alkaline. It's got juniper berries in it. Chartreuse is also really good. It's alkaline. Glenfiddich whiskey, I can't vouch for all the other spirits and drinks, but I can tell you, gin, Glenfiddich whiskey, Heineken, and the chartreuse. Chartreuse tastes horrendous to me, but it's basically like drinking a medicine. And a capful, we were told, and if you dilute that with some water, either before you go to bed or first thing in the morning, a lot of the foods that we eat have a lot of stuff in them now that our bodies can't really manage the way it used to. So there are remedies that our elders and our forefathers used to use, our foreparents used to use, that were always good to heal our bodies. And now there's addictions with a lot of things that we need to let go of. Anyways, just some interesting things to research with these things, that alcohol and a lot of things, like I was talking about cowfoot that we were raised with. Cowfoot, we were told, heals the bones because the gelatin, which is the same substance that's in jello. And then we were told that okra heals the brain, okra, and for brain injury. And then we were told that peanuts are also really good for brain injury, and so are bananas. It might be good to get organic and, you know, that kind of stuff too might help. But there are different remedies that heal the body, and everyone may be slightly different in what heals them. But there's good alcohol out there that people can utilize that can really create good remedies for the system. Thank you for some amazing comments I got today. One on grammar, I've posted some of them in the description below. And thank you to those who have sent some stuff. I really appreciate it. And thank you for all your support and the amazing information. But this has been coming to me for a while, that some of you suffering from alcoholism just need to come off of some of the the acid alcohol that's not good for the liver and the system and switch to alkaline. There's alkaline foods as well that we used to consume. And if you have access to that, that's also good too. But the medications, it might just be better to switch to a better type of alcohol and not drink as much as often. All right, everything in moderation. But yeah, there's just a lot of really interesting remedies that we just stopped utilizing. And I just started to notice that people who stopped drinking got sick and died. And I was like, I don't know what's going on. So anyways, like, share, subscribe, you guys. Have yourself a great day. But look into this stuff. And no, I'm not getting any endorsements for this. Have a great day.